Hello everyone, in this video we'll talk about the total stress, effective stress and pore pressure. For more such videos and solved examples, you can sign up on our website apsev.in. The link is given in the description. So here we are trying to understand the stress developed at a point in the soil mass due to the weight of the soil. So we know the basic formula for stress. If we say sigma is the stress, so we know it is given as total load divided by total area. So if we talk about the total stress, so total stress is nothing but the load divided by the area. So let's say we have this sample, and here at this point A, let's say this is a point, and at this point we want to find out the total stress. So let's say this height here is H1 and this height is H2. In this part the soil is dry and unit weight is gamma D, and in this part the soil is saturated. This is the water table and unit weight is gamma saturated. So the area of this sample, the cross sectional area, let's say is small a. Now if we want to write the total stress, so how can we write? We can write the total load. So total load, if we say at point A, it will be the load acting above it. So it is gamma D is the unit weight in this above part. So gamma D times H2 times A. This is the cross sectional area. So this is the volume and times unit weight. So this will give the weight due to this H2 part, or the soil in this H2 part. Similarly, for the H1 part, we can write gamma saturated times H1 times A. So this will give the total load, and stress is load divided by area. So sigma, or the total stress, we can say area I am taking as small a, because capital A I have taken for the point. So let's say this is small a here. So we get sigma as this a will cancel out. So we have gamma D H2 plus gamma saturated H1. So that way we can find out the total stress at a point in the soil mass. So we just have to take the unit weight and the depth of that particular layer, and for adding up the multiplication or the product for all such layers, we can find out the total stress. Now this total stress has two components. So total stress is given as the summation of effective stress and pore pressure. So let's understand one by one. First let's see what is pore pressure. So pore pressure, we know the soil is a two phase or three phase system depending upon if the pores are completely filled with water or not. So apart from the soil grains that are there, we also have these pores, and these pores can be filled with water or air. Now in these pores, if water is present, that is in this part, as we can see, water is there. So because of the presence of this water also, there is some stress. So we know in a tank, if we have water up to some height H, then pressure at the bottom of the tank will be unit weight of water times this height H. So in the same way, as the water is subjected to atmospheric condition in this case also, I mean basically here we are assuming that the top of this water table is at atmospheric condition. So in this case also, we can find out the pressure with a similar formula, or basically here also we have this hydrostatic distribution of pressure. So at any height we'll have the pore pressure as gamma W, that is unit weight of water, times the height. So that way we can find out this pore pressure. Pore pressure U is equal to gamma W times H. Pore pressure is also known as the neutral pressure, because if we take a point and if water is present all around this point, let's say this is the tank, and in this, and at this point if water is there along with the soil also, then the pressure due to water in all the directions will be same. So because of the pressure of water, if we have a particle, if we consider a water particle itself, or if we consider a soil particle, there is no net effect on this particle. This particle will not move in any direction because the pressure from all the directions is same. So for that reason, we call the pore pressure as neutral pressure also. Now let's talk about the effective stress. So effective stress, it is not a physical quantity. The only way to obtain effective stress is to take the difference of the two. That is, we know total stress is equal to effective stress plus pore pressure. So from here we obtain effective stress as total stress minus pore pressure. So here this total pressure and pore pressure both can be obtained by using suitable instruments. So for measuring this total pressure, an instrument called pressure cell is used, and for measuring the pore pressure we can use a standpipe. That is, at any level in the soil mass, if we want to measure the pore pressure, so we can just insert a pipe and the rise of the water in that pipe will tell us the pore pressure. That is, if we know the rise of water, let's say this is h here, then gamma w times h will give the pore pressure. So that way we can obtain both of these quantities, and taking the difference of the two we can obtain effective stress. For understanding the effective stress, we can take a microscopic view for soil. So here we have a few soil grains. So we know there will be these pores and only a small area of these particles will be in contact with each other. So if we take a plane xx, and if we want to write the total stress, so we know it will be load divided by total area. And if we want to write down this total load, so on this layer we have this contact stress that we are denoting with T, and as the load is acting in the vertical direction, or the weight will be acting in the vertical direction, so we can take the normal component here of this intergranular force. So if we take the normal component and we denote it with n dash for one particle or between these two grains, so for all the grains if we write the interparticle force, so we can write as sigma n dash, plus we also know that there is water in these pores, so because of that also there will be load on this plane, so we can write the total load due to water as the pore pressure times the area of pores, that is the area at which this pore pressure is acting. Now if we divide this equation with total area, so we have P by A is equal to sigma n dash by A plus UAW by A, where A is this total cross sectional area. Now in this equation we have left side as total stress and this term AW by A. So AW, as I said, is the area of pores and A is the total area. Now if we talk about this area at which these grains are coming in contact, so this area will be very small compared to this pore area. So we can approximate that this pore area is almost equal to total area. So this term will cancel out here and we get sigma n dash by A plus U as the total stress. Now in this equation, this term sigma n dash by A is nothing but the effective stress, that is the normal component of interparticle force divided by the total area, that gives us the effective stress. Now why this effective stress is not a physical quantity? Because if you see here, we have this interparticle force and we are dividing it by the total area. If we talk about the intergranular stress, then for that term, intergranular stress should be given as the this intergranular force divided by the contact area. This should only be divided by the contact area if we want to find out the intergranular stress. But because here we are dividing it by the total area, then it does not remain a physical quantity. Whereas intergranular stress is a physical quantity. But in the analysis of soil, when we want to understand the behavior of the soil, the shear strength or consolidation, the void ratio, compressibility, all such behaviors are affected directly by the effective stress, not by the normal stress. Calculating the intergranular stress will be very difficult. So effective stress becomes the tool with the help of which we do most of the analysis in soil. And that makes it a very important quantity in soil mechanics. Now, In the similar way as we have calculated the total stress, we can find out the effective stress. So effective stress, we can write, if we want to find out the effective stress at this point A, so we have total stress as gamma dH2 plus gamma saturated H1 and minus pore pressure. So pore pressure is gamma W times H1. So from here we get effective stress as gamma dH2 plus H1 will take out common, and we know gamma saturated minus gamma W is gamma submerged. So gamma submerged times H1, and that way we can find out the effective stress at a point in the soil mass. So here we have the formula for total stress. Then gamma W times H is the formula for pore pressure or neutral pressure, and this last one is the formula for the effective stress. I hope you found this video useful. Please like, subscribe and share this video with your friends.